When players talk about game feel, they're often referencing scoring in FIFA or getting a headshot in Call of Duty, two methodical actions at the top tier scale of AAA video games. Wild Hearts has taught me there's another level to game feel. Bonking a towering monster on the head with an enormous wooden mallet. That is Wild Hearts in its most distilled form. You run around a map hunting monsters called Kemono, slicing them up close with blades and bombarding them with wooden constructions called Karakuri. This is a far cry from Dynasty Warriors and Hyrule Warriors, the projects of yesteryear from hack and slash veteran developers Omega Force. The action is a lot more refined than ripping through monsters with aplomb. You'll need to carefully deduce the elemental type of a monster before embarking on a hunt, choosing your weapons accordingly, and studying the attack patterns of a Kemono before delving headlong into the fray. Wild Hearts trades out mindless action against hordes of foes, typical to many of Omega Force's previous games, for a more studied, prolonged fight with one humongous beast at a time. The battles against Kemono are fast and furious. The act of ducking and dodging around outstretched wings and hooves, cutting into monsters in a split second before backing off again, is utterly enthralling. It's an adrenaline-pumping experience that'll have you in a vice-like grip until the entire battle is said and done. Wild Hearts beasts are a fusion of creatures and wildlife. A pig the size of a mansion now sprouts jutting vines across the battlefield, while a raven has swollen to immense proportions. You'll need to stop and familiarize yourself with a monster and its attacks if you want to succeed, and the process helps each monster stand out in your mind long after you're done fighting them. Matching the ferocious monsters step for step is an eclectic set of weapons. Wild Hearts throws up a bladed umbrella, a giant hammer, bladed claws, a shape-shifting staff, and boisterous hand cannons, to name a few weapons you can trash the Kemono with. Each offers a bounty of different playing styles to pair with the monsters they're taking down. If you're up against a rapid Kemono, like the poisonous raven Fumebeak, a huge hammer makes little sense, so the quicker bladed umbrella is a natural fit, letting you take the fight airborne. I can't praise Wild Hearts' weapon design enough. There might be merely 9 weapon types in the hunting game, but each one is an absolute riot to use and master. The use of just 2 buttons for attacks leaves little standing between yourself and pure fun. Aiding these weapons are the Karakuri, Wild Hearts' standout feature. These wooden contraptions are what separate Omega Force's experience from its contemporaries like Monster Hunter. The system itself is simple enough. You're given a fixed number of pieces to build with, like boxes, springs, and torches, and from this births forth, well, over a dozen Karakuri contraptions. Their utility differs greatly, from giant hammers that smite monsters to bombs that detonate after just a few seconds. These contraptions are mercifully simple to activate and put together. Karakuri building blocks are all bound to the left bumper on the controller, meaning everything to do with the devices stems from one button. You won't get caught in the middle of combat, suddenly panicking and bringing up the Karakuri menu by mistake. It's always a deliberate decision, hardwired into one specific part of the controller, and by extension, your arsenal. Wild Hearts' combat is smooth and feels sublime in real time, with one unfortunate exception, the camera. The Kemono are, by nature, towering creatures, ungodly forces of nature the size of a bus, and they frequently dominate the screen when you're going toe-to-toe with them. The camera, however, doesn't pan back to take in all of a Kemono, meaning it's very easy to miss cues for attacks in these instances. It's an unfortunate damper on an otherwise fantastic experience. There's no way around it. Wild Hearts is Omega Force's take on Monster Hunter. To avoid referencing Wild Hearts in the context of Monster Hunter and the wider hunting genre would be doing it a disservice, because at last, Monster Hunter actually has serious competition. Wild Hearts is a roaring success for Omega Force. The Kemono are awe-inspiring fusions of land and creature, imposing monstrosities that leave a lasting impression long after you're done with them. The same can be said for Wild Hearts' combat system, weapons, and the Karakuri, and have a creative aspect that puts player creativity first and foremost without being overwhelming. Wild Hearts' camera might be extremely trying at times in the heat of combat, but it's hardly enough to put a damper on the entire adventure. We give it 4 stars out of 5.